Since I was given the New York Times article as a part of assignment in the digital storytelling class, I couldn't help but to be curious about this topic.
I can see how growing up in the lower and lower middle class can become challenging in the aspects of being able to take care of your children as well as have them get an education, and you as an education, I can see where the resources and the availability can become difficult. I grew up in an upper middle class family, and so it gave me a lot more opportunities in order to have extracurricular activities, grow up with a good education system, as well as have both my parents have good education as well. Being in a more upper class family, I think I've been benefited in a lot of good ways by being able to surround myself with a lot of good people. However, I also went to a public school, so I was surrounded by, you know, everybody from lower class, middle class, upper class, you know, everything was a wide array of people. And I think that I was very well-rounded and diverse of my friend group. I don't see anybody as being different due to their social economic status. I see them as being people and friends, you know.
In my opinion, it's very factual. It's real life, realizing that money rules the world no matter what, and everything's about the connections. If you're up high, the middle class, obviously as a parent, you want to make sure that your child doesn't go down to low class or middle class. I mean, you want to make sure that the family thrives. And it's just something as a parent, you don't want to see your children fail in life. So the main thing is they do what they can to improve their lives and to sustain everything. So money kind of is the way that works. Money has a lot more say in schooling, in economic potential. I just feel like money is a big factor in major decisions.
I'm an only child. Had a great childhood. I have two amazing parents that gave me everything I needed.
I thought I could fly when I was young. I mean, we were poor, but it was so much love that we didn't really notice.
We grew up in an environment where you never really knew what was going to happen, and that creates a lot of uncertainty.
Compared to previous generations, okay, we might be a bit skint, we might not be able to afford the best pair of shoes, but we're not living in poverty.
We make plenty of money. Like, we make plenty of money. It's not like we won the lottery and moved into a big fancy neighborhood.
My integrity is what I have. You know, a long time ago, people's word and integrity meant a lot.
I grew up happy in the Appalachian Mountains. We had good Christmases. We had love. I was normal. But now, what the hell am I now?
Can you hear me?
Of all developed nations, the United States has the most unequal distribution of income, and we're surging toward even greater inequality. 1928 and 2007 become the peak years for income concentration. It looks like a suspension bridge.
Last year, we made $36,000.
I probably make $50,000 a year, working 70 hours a week.
The middle class is struggling. Now, people occasionally say to me, what nation does it better? The answer is the United States. in the decades after World War II, the economy boomed, but you had very low inequality.